Welcome to another episode of Genetics in a Jiffy. Leukemia, cancer of the blood, is a disease that kills around 1,900 Australians annually. Leukemia affects white blood cells and causes proliferation of the bone marrow white blood cell progenitors, haematopoietic cells, initiating mass production of faulty white blood cells. This throws off the balance between leukocytes, erythrocytes, and platelets in the blood. When you think of leukemia, children and infants come to mind. But the disease can affect anyone, with different variants affecting different age groups. Under the tree of leukemia, there are several different branches, such as chronic lymphocytic leukemia, acute lymphocytic leukemia, acute myeloid leukemia, or chronic myeloid leukemia, or CML. The main difference between the myeloid and lymphocytic variants is the type of white blood cell affected. Lymphocytes include NK, T, and B cells, whereas macrophages, neutrophils, and basophils are myeloid cells. Myeloid leukemia generally appears innate immune responses, whereas lymphocytic leukemia affects the adaptive immune system. Both diseases cause repeat infections, anemia, and impaired clotting. Chronic variants act slowly and generally affect those over 60. In the 1950s, leukemia had a 5-year survival rate of only 14%. A breakthrough was clearly needed. Enter Peter Nowell. He was a 20th century doctor, naval officer, and cancer researcher who was interested, with his partner David Hungerford, in cancer genetics. Throughout history, cancer was thought to originate from excess bile, lymph fluid, bacteria and viruses, and from budding from cells. But the emerging field of genetics was about to put a spin on how cancer's origins were viewed. In 1914, Theodore Boveri hypothesized that mammalian tumors were caused by mitosis abnormalities, aneuploidies, and that they originate from a single cell that escapes regulation. Before Nowell and Hungerford's 1960 work on CML, several malignant chromosome aneuploidies had already been identified. Their previous studies found leukemias to possess 2N chromosomes, the expected diploid number for human cells of 23 pairs. Nowell was interested in seeing whether genetic phenomena were present in CML specifically. Unlike many great tales, this wasn't some epiphany in a meadow. Instead, Nowell and Hungerford plied their trade in the laboratories of the University of Philadelphia. Colchicine was used to fix cells in metaphase by inhibiting mitotic spindle elongation via tubulin binding. The work of identifying the chromosomes was assisted by the recent developments of GEMSA, a stain that colours the phosphate groups in DNA, and squash preparations, the process of squashing cells on a slide to easily see inside them. These were used to visualise the chromosomes via microscopy. They analysed the leukocyte chromosomes of 4 CML and acute myeloid leukemia, AML, patients. Nowell was looking for abnormal metaphase counts, a predictor of aneuploidy, of which he found no significant increase between the leukemic and normal cells. The best chance for unearthing the course of CML was thought to be gone, though the pair, good scientists, analysed the chromosomes of the 4 patients closer and found 2 samples in particular that were unusual. Deep within the fixed dividing cells, Nowell's team unearthed something strange. Nowell himself described it as a definite abnormality, probably involving the Y chromosome. This minute chromosome was present in the 2 patients suffering from CML, whilst absent in healthy people and AML patients, and named the Philadelphia chromosome. Whilst promising, more evidence was needed. The duo carried on and identified this chromosome in 7 CML patients. Nowell noted nearly 50 years after that this discovery is consistent with the long-ignored Boveri hypothesis. For 3 years after the discovery of the Philadelphia chromosome, only 1 other cancer chromosome abnormality, the Christchurch chromosome in chronic lymphocytic leukemia, had been found, though over the next decade almost all cancers had some chromosomal abnormality. Nowell's discovery paved the way for how geneticists looked at cancer, showing that the genetic chromosomal abnormalities are more present than absent in tumours. Using imaging technologies, the minute chromosome was brought into the light. Here we have a karyotype of a patient with CML and one without. The Philadelphia chromosome was identified as a fusion of chromosomes 9 and 22, not related to the Y chromosome, as Nowell thought, by Janet Rowley in the 1970s. Portions of each chromosome switch via reciprocal translocation. The mutation develops in haematopoietic myeloid progenitor somatic cells and is not heritable. The discovery of the disease's cause rapidly accelerated the hunt for a treatment. The formation of the Philadelphia chromosome created a fusion protein from the breakpoint cluster region, BCR, and ABL, a cancer-causing oncogene, which created an always active tyrosine kinase. Without the BCR component, ABL kinases need to be activated by an activator peptide. But once mutated, the active enzyme can phosphorylate tyrosine growth factors constitutively, causing cell proliferation and cancer. CML could then be treated with tyrosine kinase inhibitor drugs, such as imatinib and dasitinib, which inhibit activity by binding to the ATP site in the kinase domain. Nowell passed away in 2016, but his work paved the way for improvements in cancer diagnosis and treatment and has vastly improved the lives of many of the expected 8,450 people diagnosed with CML each year. His work also solidified the genetic basis of leukemia and set the groundwork for cancer genetics in the years to come.